That food in our tummy, that life we was living ain't funny. But you cannot take nothing from me. Put that on my mama, my daughter, my cousin, my brother. I showed. Way better than I can tell you. The type of dreams that they sell you. That's why I learned from my failures. Don't do the handouts or the favors. Told my brother I'ma get this paper. Was left behind, I'll see it later. To keep it real, you don't need to wait up. Lay it all on the line, ain't no looking back. Giving my all with no strings attached. Can't run the bottom, roll through the cracks. Spotlight on you behind you, my ass.
I remember sleeping with my ribs touched. I remember sleeping with my ribs touched. Now I get it go. I remember sleeping with my ribs touched. I remember sleeping with my ribs touched. Now I get it go. Remember sleeping with my ribs touched.
DA Sports coverage of the NFL playoffs brings us to a sold-out and absolutely rocking Mercedes-Benz Superdome in downtown New Orleans. Coming up, an important divisional round matchup in the NFC between the Carolina Panthers and the New Orleans Saints. Two spots in the NFC title game awaits the winner here as we're underway in the divisional round of the NFL playoffs. And they're going to start this drive in pretty good shape as they get it up past the 30.
The Panthers take over first and 10 at their own 34-yard line.
From the 34 now, here's first and 10. On the first down completion.
It's a gain of eight.
A good safe pass there right off the bat.
That's almost a rhythm play. That's what we like to call it. Get them into rhythm early, something safe, something they're confident about, something they feel good. And once that's completed, then you just keep moving from there because the confidence elevates.
Facing a second and two after that last catch, good for 8 yards. Here's the first carry for Austin Eckler. And nothing doing. He's immediately taken down at the line of scrimmage. He got maybe a half yard at most, but officially they'll be left with a third and two. They'll try to pick up the first with Eckler. Well, this is going to depend on the spot, but it's not a very generous one. He looks to be about a yard or so short. Just a 1 yard gain on the play, and that'll mean a call to the punt team as it's fourth down. They're going for it. It's Hill. He's going to have his running back. It's complete. And he gets it down to the 48, enough for the first. A big roll of the dice on fourth and one, but it pays off. They convert. The fourth down run successful. Now they look to pay it off on first down. Off of play action, Hill. He'll buy some time right. And his throw is going to be incomplete. He was looking to get that one to DJ Moore. And now it's second down.
That was an interesting look there because as soon as he got outside the pocket, I thought he was going to take off and run for yardage. But what often happens now with these quarterbacks who can move, defenses want to try and keep bodies in front of them. And I think that discouraged him from taking off and made him try a pass downfield that fell incomplete.
5 yards. Now it's third and five.
That's a really nice job by them picking up the run blitz and detecting it and blocking it and turning it into a nice run. And a lot of times you think if you blitz a running play, you're going to smother it. But a lot of the blitzers, they come in a little bit high. They don't have great leverage, and they're easily blocked and turned to the side.
From the gun on third, Hill. And a big loss here as he's taken down. Aaron Donald tracks him down way in the backfield for a loss of 16. So on fourth down, kicking it away here, Michael Pilardi. And he He gets it away, a directional kick going toward the sideline. And this will be up to the ruling of the side judge here. He says it crossed out of bounds at the 16-yard line. So the ball down to the 16 here for first and 10. Now a play fake here on first down. And a catch made. This is Emmanuel Sanders. He'll be tagging down, but not before they work it across midfield. The catch and run pays off to the tune of 35 yards.
First and 10 at the 49.
So the line of scrimmage moves all the way across the 50 now as they come up first and 10. Winston. Able to get this to go. And a 6-yard gain gets him right around the 43.
Well, from their point of view, this game could not be starting out much better, could it? Force a punt on defense, and now they're moving it crisply on offense.
Crisply, I like that. Yeah, moving it very, very well. Looks like the defense on their heels a little bit. You put a score in here, long way to go. Sports coverage of the NFL playoffs brings us to a sold-out and absolutely rocking Mercedes-Benz Superdome in downtown New Orleans. Coming up, an important divisional round matchup in the NFC between the Carolina Panthers and the New Orleans Saints. One of two spots in the NFC title game awaits the winner here as we're underway in the divisional round of the NFL playoffs. Hill. Open man Samuel complete. He'll be taken down, but not before they work it across midfield. 28 yards the gain there on the catch and run.
But one of the ways that quarterbacks keep all the receivers alive in a play
Never lock in on any one guy. Make sure you keep your eyes moving, scan the field. And here he finds the open guy for a nice pickup.
A shotgun snap for Hill. And he's got the hookup to Moore. And he is tackled inside the 40, not quite to the 35. Last week in the wild card win, he had 7 catches. That's his first one here.
First down, Panthers.
So from the 36 now, first and 10. From the gun, here's Hill, flushed out right. And this will be incomplete. Physical play on the football there, and it's second down.
Normally being a big-bodied receiver plays to their advantage downfield. Go up and make the catch, take the hit, and pick up yardage. But in this case, the hit was timed really well and popped it free from his grasp.
They'll try again from the 36 on second and 10. Throwing again. Hill. And he'll be hit as he releases it. And that'll fall incomplete. Looking to go back to Thomas again. But now it'll be third down.
Pressure, and that's certainly going to be a key to this game going forward. And that time, they were able to get in there and influence the throw. And remember, quarterbacks got to get rid of it. They don't have the tuck rule that they can fall back on anymore.
And now the Saints are going to take a timeout on defense. They'll have 2 remaining as we step aside here in this first quarter. Now they face a 3rd and 10 after back-to-back incompletions. And again, it's Hill. He lets this one fly toward the back of the end zone. And he's got his man. It's Samuel. Touchdown, Carolina.
Samuel. Touchdown.
Curtis Samuel. 36 yards. And the Panthers are going to take a first quarter lead. And this will be good to give the Panthers a 7-0 lead.
Makes the score Panthers 7, Saints nothing. Joey Sly to kick off.
Joey Sly now to kick off after the touchdown. Taken about 7 yards deep. And beyond the 20, but not by much. In fact, just a yard pass there to the 21.
Take over first and 10 at their own 22-yard line.
Winston and the Saints now with a 1st and 10 at their own 22. This is the Oklahoma State alum, Chris Carson. And he'll take this one up close to the 25-yard line.
The tackle made by
2 yards on the pickup there. It'll be 2nd and 8.
Oh, that's a real nice job there by the defensive front. They just engaged and held their ground. But how about the guy who made the play? We often talk about whether they take a good first step or not. Many times you just don't take any step. Just get your feet moving, get your body going. And then once he made the read, he was able to make the play.
Being chased out left. He'll wind up getting 4 there on his own, but it will leave him now with a 3rd down situation.
Now how about that play? He took a possible negative and turned it into positive yardage and slid down to avoid taking a big shot. Excellent job getting down and avoiding the big hit.
To throw it. And that's caught by Smith. Able to rip off a big chunk of yardage before being dropped inside the 40. They'll get 34 yards there.
8-yard line.
Now it's Carson. Take this one down to the 36. Give him a couple on the carry there. 2nd and 8.
Certainly a nice job there by the defense, rallying to the football and getting him on the ground. But I think the play gets made by the defensive front, because if they can't get upfield, their job is to go ahead and get low, almost get into a ball sometimes, stack things up, and make it difficult for the runner to find a hole.
It's a first down on a gain of 10.
I like the screen being called here early in the game, especially on the opening drive, because, Brandon, when guys come out of the locker room, especially those pass rushers, they are so amped up to get to the quarterback that you can use that against them, and a screen pass is a great way of doing it. A lot of teams against good pass rushing teams, they want to run the screen 10 to 12 times in a game.
It's incomplete.
Nice play there to force the incompletion. And to me, one thing's for sure. When you're the underdogs and you're playing on the road, you absolutely have to get takeaways. You've got to get the ball from them.
Yeah, win that turnover battle, going to be key. They didn't get one there, but you get the feeling they keep making plays like that, they might just get a few.
Yeah, once you get one, defensive teams think they come in bunches.
And he'll get it down inside the 20 to the 18-yard line. That'll leave them with a third and two coming up. They got 8 yards there.
That's a gain of 8. Brings up third and 2.
Trying to keep the drive going here. This is play number 7 on third and 2. He can run for it, and he will. He'll grab 3 yards on the play, taking it himself for the first down.
Now, that was a designed run. Now, remember, if a quarterback goes feet first, he's protected. But if he dives head first, he's not. On that play, he figured the risk was worth the reward.
Line of scrimmage, the 15. It's first and 10. They'll run on first down. Carson. And he is into the end zone. Touchdown, New Orleans. Touchdown run. And the Saints are within an extra point of tying this thing up. A solid blocking up front from the guys on the offensive line allowed him to get in for the touchdown.
Yeah, some might say that the guys on the offensive line were in concert. I used to have a coach who called it marrying up, meaning when you get on a guy, you just stay right there. Each guy has his own assignment that allowed the runner to make the big move towards the end zone.
Decision to bring it out ends up not being a good one. Costs him about 5 yards as he's tackled at the 20.
First and 10 at their own 20-yard line.
The Panthers out there and ready to begin their next drive. And they had to wait a long time to get the football back. Probably not what you were hoping for when you got an offense that's humming.
Agreed. What you were looking for is the defense get the ball back pretty quickly, right? Hoping for a 3-and-out. So that didn't happen. You can't yell at your D for that. They've got to take care of their own business and reestablish themselves now that they're back on the field.
15 yards is the pickup there, and the drive starting very nicely. First down.
Carolina. I know this may be jumping the gun a little bit, but 7-7, they're flinging it around like crazy. Look at the drive that's going on here. Partner, we may have to start thinking about one of these defenses just holding someone to a field goal and maybe trying to get advantage that way.
Looking left side, that's caught by Moore. A gain of 6 there on first.
One thing you're hoping for when you run drag routes, you're able to hit a receiver in stride, and he can pick up a lot of yardage after the catch. But in this situation, the defense was effective, able to stop him before you get a good head of steam going.
Here's a throw that's taken in out of the backfield. And he'll be taken down, but not before he works it past the 50. 11 yards there, first down.
Well, they've certainly done a nice job spreading the ball around on this drive. This time he gets it out to his back, and it's another nice play and another first down. They've got the defense on their heels a little bit. They're reacting instead of being aggressive and making plays.
Hill on first down. He's going to look deep for Moore. And this is caught. A big play there for Carolina. 47 yards.
We saw these guys have some big plays in their wild card win last week, and they're certainly going to need to continue to put up plays like we just saw there if they hope to continue to move on in these playoffs.
Trying to power it in with Armour. Power on power, but he's not going to get in. It's going to be second and goal.
No gain on the play. Leads to second.
Another shot from the one on second and goal. These two teams all tied after one.
7-7.
They come out five wide, three of them to the right side. Another shot from the one on second and goal. From the gun, Hill escaping the pressure right toward the end zone, but that's going to wind up incomplete.
That's a good decision there. He was looking, and he was looking, but the coverage was excellent. Nice job to get rid of it and try and find something better on third and goal. He didn't let that clock accelerate and force him into an error.
A big one coming in this divisional round playoff, third and goal. They'll go with the keeper, and he takes it into the end zone for a Panthers touchdown.
Carolina.
Taysom Hill with his second touchdown here in this first half. And the Panthers have taken the lead. And he's got it. It's now a 14-7 ball game.
Makes the score Panthers 14, Saints 7. Joey Sly to kick off for Carolina.
So not much time to speak of remaining in this first half as the kick's away. Fielded in the end zone. And he'll be stopped right around where he would have been had he gone down to a knee, maybe a yard shy of there at the 24.
At their own 24-yard line.
Getting set for their next drive, the New Orleans offense. They trail a one-score deficit, 14-7, as they come up first and 10. And he is met at the line of scrimmage, and he goes down right there. No gain on the play. It'll be second down.
No gain on the play.
Early down stuff should put this offense in precarious position. We know that securing the point of attack, especially against the big-bodied guys in the middle of this D, has got to be priority one.
Second down, Winston.
Time. It looked like he tried to put a little too much air under this one, and it turned into a floater. And defensively, this is a dream. He could have fair caught that one. That was way too easy.
Here's Hill now after the interception. Eluding the pressure right. He's going to take off with it. And all the way down inside the 5 to the 4. Nothing open downfield. He keeps it himself for 11 and a first down.
Man, defensively, that hurts. They got him out of his rhythm. They had him hemmed in, but somehow he was able to tuck it away and get away for a gain.
They'll try and run for it on first and goal. And he'll be stopped about a yard shy of the goal line after a pickup of about 3.
The ball carrier.
That run didn't get very far, and I think when you're looking at his dimensions, he's a little bit on the smaller side. He's counting on the big guys up front to escort him in, and they couldn't create any kind of space for him, could they?
Yeah, didn't get the push they needed. And he's got it. Touchdown, Panthers. Austin Eckler there to make the grab, and the Panthers add on to their lead. So simple math here in the first half. They've had 3 drives offensively, and they have scored every time, and they've got the lead.
Well, whenever we talk about adjustments, we usually talk about an offense making adjustments, right? This is all about the defense. They've got to figure out some way, somehow, to slow them down. Do they blitz a little bit more? Do they play more zone coverage? Right now, they don't know where to go because they're hitting them in every direction.
And ultimately cannot get this out to the 25-yard line as he's dropped it to 23.
First and 10. At their own 23-yard line.
The Saints offense on the field, ready to get their drive started. A tale of two extremes already in this game. A touchdown pass on their opening drive, followed by an interception last time out.
Now, it sounds like things balance out, right? What's that mythological thing that we do? If you have a candy bar, have a diet soda with it, it balances it out. And we know that's not really true, right? Because the interception, that sting lingers a little bit longer. Got to come out now and put together some nice plays.
This one across the 35. 11 yards there. First down.
I'm okay with the call there. In fact, I actually like it. I know they're down a couple of scores, but the running game worked in that situation. I would continue to go in that direction.
So here's a first and 10 at the 38. On play action, Winston. He'll air it out deep for Thomas. Man, it's caught inside the 10. And he is in. Touchdown, New Orleans. Michael Thomas, 62 yards. And the Saints have cut it back within a score. It's up and good. This becomes a 21-14 ball game now.
It's the score, Panthers 21, Saints 14.
So not much time to speak of remaining in this first half as the kick's away. Taken in the end zone. And ultimately cannot get this out to the 25-yard line as he's dropped at the 23.
Take over first and 10 at their own 23-yard line.
The Panthers out there and ready to begin their next drive. And the ledger for them so far looks pretty good, doesn't it?
It certainly does. Touchdown, touchdown, touchdown. Not sure it can be much better than that. They've got to feel very good about the groove that they're in at this stage of the game.
Here's a throw, complete right side to start things out. And he's going to get this one across the 30-yard line. 10 yards there to start the drive, and just enough by about the length of the football for a first down. On first down, Eckler. And he'll work this one up to about the 38. Credit the tackle to DJ Swearinger.
Brandon, 5 yards on that run. Let's get back to the huddle and make sure if you're a back, you spend time with your offensive line and give them credit. Hard to move those 300-plus pounders at the line of scrimmage, and they did for a significant chunk of yardage. He did a fine job there of not hitting him before the ball arrived, and I've got to tell you, you can often mistime that play because of the angles of approach. When you're going to get him, sometimes you panic as well and think, I've got to be there right now. Instead, in this case, timed it perfectly and knocked it free.
They come up now, 3rd and 5, following the incomplete pass. Operating from the gun, Hill. He's got a first down and then some at midfield. And that is incomplete.
And that's one of those plays where it's hard to keep two eyes on the football when you know the contact's coming, let alone getting two hands around it, hugging it to your body, and absorbing the hit, even for those big tight ends who you would think could absorb that contact.
And this one will not be returnable as it sails out of bounds.
Take over first and 10 at their own 16-yard line.
Getting set for their next drive, the New Orleans offense. And they're hoping to redo their efforts in the last drive when they got into the end zone.
And just think of what it's like now on the sideline. Because when you score a touchdown, you have to go up and look at the tablet and see what you did on the last drive. When you scored points, it's a whole lot better view than when you're trying to figure out how to fix things there.
Not much there, only a yard. Here's 2nd and 9. They run it with Carson. And he'll take this up only to about his 18-yard line. Only a yard on the pickup there, and it'll bring up a 3rd down.
The best defensive linemen, they play with great leverage so they can get low and not get bowled over by offensive linemen. They have excellent hands. They can throw people off on a play. We just saw a great example of a really good run stop by a guy playing the defensive tackle position.
And he's got it past the 30 before he's hit and dropped. His first reception of the divisional round matchup, but it's good for a first down as well. He's been the forgotten man in this first half. Not a guy you want to forget. Not only his first catch, first time they targeted him.
That doesn't make any sense, does it?
Not
because
at all.
Those are the types of plays that he provides when he does come.
Looking for Sanders, and it's intercepted. He's picked off just shy of midfield. And the return stops at the 39-yard line. We remind you, as we've done all year, that coming up at halftime, we will visit with Jonathan Coachman, standing by in Orlando. He'll let you know what's going on here. A very eventful divisional round weekend. 7 yards, the pick up there.
Complete to Curtis Samuel. A 7-yard pickup.
Able to get seven on that first down pass play. Second and three. From the gun, Hill. Incomplete. It was a veteran safety, Malcolm Jenkins, who got a hand in there to disrupt it.
Receiver coaches preach to their guys all the time, separation, that's what's going to make the play successful. That time there was very little, and I think they were actually fortunate that it was only knocked away and not intercepted.
So the incomplete pass on the last play, and that leads us to a third and three. Operating from the gun, Hill. Target, that's Moore. And inside the 20 before he's brought down. 14 yards, good for a Panther first down.
First down, Carolina.
So from inside the 20, here's first and 10 at the 18. Now Hill looking to throw on first. Say it's incomplete. He was trying to find Keith Kirkwood that time, and that'll bring up second down.
I think he's got to be careful not to force anything into coverage right there. There weren't really any throwing lanes, but the best part for him, he's got second and third down to fall back on.
So now second and 10 after the incompletion on first down. To throw again. Hill to the right side, and he's got more complete. And he'll take it from the 18 to the 15, a gain of three. Now we'll get a quick timeout called by New Orleans, number two. As they get the stoppage with just under 50 seconds remaining in half number one. The last catch did get three, but they're still left needing 7 yards on third down. Throwing again is Hill. He'll get this to Eckler. And he's got this inside the 10 to the 9 before he's out of bounds. 6 yards on the pickup, and that's going to bring up a fourth down.
Fourth down.
Now the Panthers going to use the first of their timeouts as they'll stop it with just over 40 seconds to go in the first half. Joey Sly on now for the Panthers. From the right hash, and this one just a chippy. And this one is right through. And the lead works its way up to 10, 24-14. That drive took him inside the 10. Good job defensively to hold him to three.
Yeah, I like how you did that. Give a little tip of the cap to the stop troops there, because they didn't give up a touchdown in that situation, right? Made him kick the field goal. And yeah, points went against them, but that feels a whole lot better running off the field.
Dante Jackson on the return. The Saints take over first and 10 at their own 24-yard line.
The Saints offense on the field, ready to get their drive started. And you're under a minute to go in the half, a first half that hasn't been particularly kind to you. How do you think they'll play this?
Well, I think the smart approach is to run out the clock, lick your wounds at the half, and see if you can come up with a strategy to play better in the second. But it's also something to challenge your offense right here. You know, hey, guys, you help dig this hole. See if you can get us out of it a little bit before the half run lines out. Let's go make some plays.
A good rally to the football keeps him to only a yard, and it's second down. And he'll push forward here for a good little run as the clock continues to run. And this offense going to elect to burn a timeout with 5 seconds remaining in quarter number two. And they line up now for what will likely be the last play of the first half. One more time, they'll keep it on the ground. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. So we've come upon halftime here in this NFC Divisional Round matchup. As we send you on over to Orlando for Jonathan Coachman in our EA Sports Halftime Report. Take it away, Coach. A trip to the NFC title game hanging in the balance. Second half action back underway. Fielded in the end zone. And he'll be brought down shy of the 20, so the decision to bring it out of the end zone, not a good one.
The Saints take over first and 10 at their own 18-yard line.
Getting set for their next drive, the New Orleans offense. They trail offense, first time to touch the ball in quarter three, and we'll see what they can do.
And I can't wait to see what they have planned, because some teams script to start a half. Other teams just go, okay.
They got his man, complete. And he will finally be taken out of bounds. A big time play there for New Orleans. 68 yards. From the 13 now, they work on first and 10. From the red zone now, Winston. It's Thomas. It's a touchdown for the Orleans. Michael Thomas. Two catches, two touchdowns here so far. And the Saints are back within a score. It's up and good, and this now becomes a 24-21 ball game.
24. Saints 21.
Morstead out now following the touchdown to kick. Taken in the end zone. And he's up past the 20 to the 22-yard line.
The Panthers take over first and 10 at their own 22-yard line.
The Panthers out there and ready to begin their next drive. Pretty important third quarter drive for them. Momentum has sort of shifted the other direction after that last touchdown as they nurse this small lead. Here's Eckler to begin the drive. And he'll get about three as he takes this up near the 25.
The ball carrier.
In the first half, he was held in check on the ground, but despite that lack of production, they still have the lead.
Yeah, and they've got to feel fortunate about that. If they could actually get production from their lead horse, that would help open up this offense and widen this margin, too.
Three yards on that last carry. Here's second and seven. They go play fake, and it's Hill. In double coverage, and it's intercepted. Picked up by Marshawn Lattimore. Before we came up to the booth, last thing he said as we were walking off the field, want to play mistake-free football. Well, that just went out the window there with a pick.
And do you remember what you said to me when we were walking up to the booth after he said that? You're like, oh, fatal last words. Every time we hear that, things tend to fall apart a little bit, and that's what we saw there. Didn't get enough on that throw, and it turned into an interception.
Now a pass dumped off to his running back. And he'll lose yardage here. Back at the 41. But despite the completion, they're going to wind up losing three there. Second down.
Well, I know it goes against the instincts of the person catching the ball, because all you're ever taught is catch the football, don't drop it.
But drop it there.
Yeah, in that situation, dropping it would have been better. End up losing yardage, even though they completed the pass.
As good as a sack.
Yeah, how about that? Although they won't get the same credit for it, and it won't help them at contract time.
On the second down screen play.
For a second there, I thought that might break big. Screen pass. Looked like it was coming together. Looked like there was an opening. Still, ended up with a solid game.
Third and short yardage, Winston. The open man is Smith. And they'll work it inside the 15-yard line before it's all said and done. 17 there and a New Orleans first down. Here's a first and 10 at the 14-yard line. On first down, it's Carson. And this play goes nowhere. Losing yardage back to the 15. Officially, it's a one-yard loss. That's going to bring up second and 11.
Second and 11 at the 15-yard line.
Second and 11. Now Winston. Gordon open, completes it. And he's able to work it here to the 8-yard line. Complete. Give him six on the play, and that'll make it third down.
Got that look from me there, partner. I think we're on the same page on that one. Just his first catch. I think we both thought he'd be a little more active in the passing game. Let's see if that's the start of them trying to get the ball to him a little bit more here in the second half.
Jameis intercepted a third time. He's at the 50, he's at the 30, the 20, and he will score. Touchdown, Panthers.
That's the way to get it going, boy.
Ah, yes, the old tip drill works to perfection there.
Ah, you bring back great memories. Used to love that drill. And a lot of times in practice, you work on it, not just one tip, but multiple tips, just in case the ball stays in the air for a while, to have an awareness and the ability to go up and grab it, and then you want to get some blocking support and end up in the opposite end zone.
In that tip drill, what do you yell?
For us, it was Oski. Okay, Oski was an interception.
For different teams.
Different teams have different ways of doing it. I've heard bingo, jackpot. The worst I ever heard, though, was Frankenstein. You don't want it to be a three-syllable word.
Yeah.
You want to get it right down and go. Oski is really the preferred word.
Oski. Winston and the Saints now with a first and 10 at their 25-yard line. And he'll be upended at the 28-yard line. Just a 3-yard gain there.
He was brought down.
Well, that's just a pile of bodies there, and that's when you kind of find out who's a tough guy, right? Who can stand up and make a play. It was only a 3-yard run, but for both sides, they had to walk away from that feeling like, okay, I can stand up when the going gets tough in here.
On second and 7, Winston looking long for Thomas. That's caught inside the 20. Touchdown, New Orleans. Michael Thomas. Saving his best for the playoffs with his third touchdown of the game. And the Saints have cut it back within a score. And the lead is down to a field goal now.
Makes the score Panthers 31, Saints 28.
Morstead out now following the touchdown to kick. Takes this about 5 yards deep. And he's able to get this across the 20, but not by much, as he's marked down officially at the 21.
Take over first and 10 at their own 21-yard line.
The Panthers out there and ready to begin their next drive. Their lead down to a field goal now as they start with a first and 10. They started on the ground with Eckler. Take it ahead to the 28-yard line. It's a 6-yard gain on the ground, and that'll make it second and 4.
Getting had a ton of success here so far, but you get the feeling that he might be on the verge of popping one.
Yeah, even on that one, there was a little bit of a hole, but it closed there quickly at the end. Second and 4. to his right. Toward the right sideline, but it's incomplete. Austin Eckler, the intended target, and it's third and four.
Well, you most certainly don't want to go three and out here and get the football right back because your friend, Old Momentum, he's wondering if he should change sidelines about right now. And if you don't convert here, guess what? He's going to make the trek to the opposite side, and all of a sudden, you've got a battle on your hands.
And he takes a shot on the release as this will be incomplete.
And that's a really good job there defensively. They went into this possession knowing that they needed to get a stop. They're in a tight ball game, and they got it done. Great work to force the three and out. Got the football right back for their offense. They've got to go to the sidelines feeling pretty good about themselves and encouraging their offensive mates to get some points.
46 on his first kick. This one in that neighborhood as well. Coverage there holds him to a 2-yard return following a 50-yard punt. And the Saints will take over with a first down and 10. The Saints offense on the field ready to get their drive started. And things are starting to move in the right direction. They get the touchdown last drive and their defense gets them the football back.
Yeah, now they have a chance to get the lead if they can put something together here. I'm eager to see how they decide to do it. They want to be methodical, or do they want to take the big strike and go after it right now?
Second and 12 at the 19-yard line.
Second down and 12 at the 19-yard line. To throw is Winston. They'll run the screen with Carson. He'll be dropped at the 25 after a gain of 6.
Oh, I came to my feet on that one. I thought he was getting close to breaking that one big, but in the end, give some credit to the defense, finding a way to get to him and forcing a third down.
On third down, Winston. It's too strong. They get there, taken down. Brian Burns coming in to drop him for a loss of 8, and it also brings up fourth. Now here's Morstead now as he sends this one away. He's going to be out of bounds on what's going to wind up being the final play. One quarter remains for a trip to the NFC title game. We'll return with more after this break. You're watching the NFL on EA Sports. The Panthers out there and ready to begin their next drive. And this has been a tight game to this point. Of course, they usually are at this juncture of the playoffs. But with the lead and the football, the clock right now, their friend, as they try to book their spot in the conference championship next Sunday. And he'll be taken down, but not before they work it across midfield. 28 yards the gain there on the catch and run.
First down.
So in Saints territory now, here's first and 10 at the 46. Off of play action, Hill. That's into the hands of Eckler. And he'll go down inside the 45 before going out of bounds. They'll contain him to just 4, second down.
A gain of 4. It's now second and 6.
4 yards on that last completion, so that sets up second and 6. A shotgun snap for Hill. Taking a shot for Samuel. And look at this. They get the turnover they needed. It's intercepted. Picked off by Malcolm Jenkins. And they'll be down just outside of the end zone at the 1-yard line. A critical error there in a tight game of the fourth.
All you talk about is taking care of the football, and especially with a lead here in the fourth quarter. Turning it over, now the door is open for the opposition.
Just in general, when you're passing in the fourth quarter with a lead, no matter what point, you got to be super careful.
Got to be careful, and sometimes you can be so careful that you end up running yourself into an error.
Ready,
getting set for their next drive, the New Orleans offense. And this certainly a key moment in this game, trailing by three, fourth quarter, with a spot in the championship game next weekend on the line. Here's a quick throw caught by Smith. And he's only able to get it to right around the three. That catch good for only a couple.
The goal of a wide receiver screen is get enough blockers in front to create a wall and let him pick his spot to run the football. How about the defense there swarming to it and not allowing that to happen? Did not let him get downfield.
On second down, it's Carson. And he will go out of bounds up around the 45-yard line. A big hitter there from deep in their own territory. 43 yards on the ground.
The 45-yard line.
So that changes things. Here's first and 10 all the way up at the 45. From the gun, Winston. And for the fourth time tonight, it's an interception. He's picked off at his own 47. And he will bring this one back. It's a pick six for a Panther touchdown.
It goes without saying, but I'm going to say it anyway. That's a ball he would like to have back, and it lands right in the lap of the defender from there. He doesn't have very far to go before he gets to the end zone, and he got there in a hurry.
Extra point right down the middle, and his guys will take a 10-point lead. So they throw the pick six. They'll get another shot at it now as this one's in the air. Fields it in the middle of the end zone. And he'll be stopped right around where he would have been had he gone down to a knee, maybe a yard shy of there at the 24.
At their own 24-yard line.
The Saints offense on the field, ready to get their drive started. And this could be the defining moment of their season, all hyperbole aside. You're trailing here in the fourth quarter, the divisional round. They need to come up with something as they get this drive started. I want to go back to something you said in the first quarter.
Is it a positive?
It is a positive.
Okay.
About winning the turnover battle as a visiting team, as an underdog. You were right. They've done just that, and look where it's gotten them.
It's part of the formula. When you go on the road, as you mentioned, being an underdog, winning the turnover battle is a big key, and this one's playing out in this one.
Target that time, Michael Thomas. And that takes us from second to third down.
Well, so far on this drive, they've done some good work. They force incompletions on first and second down, bring up third and 10. That brings up the big question. Do they bring pressure, or do they play coverage on this down?
The Saints on third down. They've been very good, 5 for 7 thus far. This is third and 10. Now they go screen. It's complete. Boy, he is very close to a first down, but from where they're spotting that football, he's going to be a foot or so short. They'll get 10 there, but it leaves him just short for fourth down. Keep hope alive here on fourth down. They're going for it. Desperation time. Winston on fourth down. It's complete. Swings it out to his running back. And he gets this up across the 35 before he's out of bounds. The time to pull out the stops is now, and they convert there on fourth down. The fourth down run successful. Now they look to pay it off on first down. Jameis again. And it's hauled in by Jared Cook. And a 6-yard gain gets him right around the 43. They're giving those short little routes. Tackled him in bounds, too. They're just not wanting to get beat over the top.
Yeah, and if you can't really get downfield, take the short routes. But now you got to have guys who can actually break tackles and increase those gains.
Line of scrimmage, the 43 on second and 4. They'll let this thing go for Sanders. And my goodness, another interception. Cordray Tankersley with a pick. And he'll take this back all the way up past the 45-yard line. I think you and I were a little surprised back earlier in the game. when he threw his second interception. I mean, who would have thought a quarterback of his caliber picked now five times?
It's beyond stunning to me because we're used to that with maybe a quarterback with less experience or less talent. But a quarterback of his caliber, I can't believe what we've just seen.
Absolutely. If you would have told me this coming into the ballgame, I would have said never. Not in a million years, but here we go.
1 yard gain brings up second and nine at the 47-yard line.
Second and nine. It's Eckler again. He'll get three up to midfield. And now, defensively, they're going to burn their first timeout. Remember, they get an extra time built in coming up here shortly at the two-minute warning. The Panthers on third down. They've hit it 50%, 3 of 6 to this point. This will be third and six. Flushed out right. And he took the contact as he was throwing it. And the ball drops incomplete.
Oh, that's got to frustrate him a little bit because they nearly got to him there. And it would have been the first sack of the game instead. They're able to influence the release, and they did force the incomplete pass.
And the kick's away as he angles this one for the sideline. And out of bounds, sailed over, looked like right near the pylon. This one's going to be perfect. Directional kicking at its finest, right down at the 1 yard line. Getting set for their next drive, the New Orleans offense. Their defense was able to force the punt. That's the good news. But this is still a two-score game, and they need points on this drive. And in a relatively quick manner. And brought in by the tight end, Cook. And he's going to get a solid gain of 9 before being brought down. Second and right at a yard. So it's Saints football as we get you reset. And let's see what they've come up with offensively after having time to talk it over. Throwing again on second down. Winston, he's going to let it fly. And this is intercepted, and that should do it. Cordray Taker's able to pick, and his guys are going to get the football at the 37-yard line.
They're on 37-yard line.
Coming out with a jumbo package to start the drive. They'll try and run some clock here as they keep it on the ground. And I think this defense knew what was coming as he is smothered behind the line. They'll lose a yard there, and it's second and 11.
Brings up second and 11.
A loss of a yard there to start out. That leads to a second and 11. Down to a knee here. The defense still with a couple of timeouts. We'll see if they want to use them.
It's a loss of a yard. And it's third down.
That's the reason we ball for. Circle round twice for the encore. You know, you know.
So time to start going in the other direction as they come up now third and long. They'll try and run some clock here as they keep it on the ground. And he'll go out near midfield at the 49. 14 yards, good for a Panther first down. His longest run of the game right there, and a pretty good time for it. A huge third down conversion late.
Love the mindset. Love the way he flipped the switch late in the game, needed a big run, and helped produce it with great leverage from the offensive line. But you also know what happens, too. The defense stacks the line. So if you can break through that first barrier, there's usually plenty of room to run.
47-yard line.
And they'll indeed take a knee.
Kill on the keeper. A loss of a yard on the play. And it's third down.
The last two plays each lose a yard. They'll try to move forward here on third and 12. They go down to...